Bang from Marcello, bad little bitch, she Spanish, speak no English.
Fat boy.
And I don't wanna go crazy, but every thug needs a lady. Girl, it feel like you and I been more than together, inseparable. You chose pain over pleasure, for that you forever be a part of me. Mind, body, and soul, ain't no I in we, baby. When you cry, who wipes your tears? When you scared, who's telling you this? Nothing to fear, girl, I'll always be there. When you need a shoulder to lean on, never hesitate, knowing you can call on your soulmate, and vice versa. That's why I be the first.
Induced. Got our bag. Got a whole bunch of snacks.
I'm on the way to the hospital to get induced. I'll be 39 weeks tomorrow. Can't really see it. It's my first anyway. But I'll be 39 weeks tomorrow. My appointment's at 8. It's about 7:30 right now, so we should be getting there just at 8 or around 8:05. And I'll record process.
So we're here at the hospital. It's what time is it?
I don't know.
8:38. You just got here. Cause a big dumb dumb right there. And we ran into traffic. Wait, no, first one of the lights was out on Highway 85. Then we ran into traffic. Then we ran into two trains. And we finally got here. Then we couldn't go through the main entrance, so we had to go and walk around through the emergency room entrance. Then they had to check our bags, all the bags, and then we just now getting up here. They said it's gonna be a while before I actually like get in there, but I'm hungry as hell. I'm finna eat. Okay guys, it's 10:48 and we just now getting in our room. I have to get a urine sample, and then I have to slip into something more comfortable. So I'm gonna put this on in my bed. I'm waiting on the doctor to come in and hook me up into the computer. I mean, into the machine or whatever. What are you doing? He done wrote on the board and he won't come off. Okay, yeah, I'm waiting on them to come in here and hook me up. That's how they got me hooked up. Put it down. They ain't did shit yet. Okay, so. They put the balloon in me and I started to feel contractions, and now plus I had the little pill in me too, so I had to use the bathroom heavy too. And then like the whole time while I was getting up, like, I was shaking, and then Justin took forever because he didn't know how to unplug the thing. He didn't know how to unplug this thing while I was getting up. Like, I kept shaking and stuff like that. And when I went to use the bathroom, the balloon fell out. Meaning that I'm now 4 centimeters. So, they're going to call the people in here to see what they're going to do next. It's 11:40 a.m. They got me doing the peanut ball thing. I got pain medicine twice. I forgot the name of it, but twice it's really helping with the contractions. Can't really feel anything. They just checked my cervix. I'm 5 centimeters. That's kind of good. Hopefully I can, this peanut ball is supposed to help me dilate faster. Yeah, I'm ready to go. I'm over this. So they put me on this peanut ball. You know, the little big exercise ball. That's basically what it is, an exercise ball, but it's shaped like a peanut. So they put the ball between my legs. They had me lay on my left side and they had me lay on my right side. I did two sets. I lay on my left side and then they'll put the balloon between my legs. At first it wasn't all the way, it was all the way down, and I just had the ball between my legs, and then they told me to bend my knee. So that helped. I did that on the left side once and then on the right side. Then we went back and then they pushed the ball up a little further towards me, and I had to do the same thing. Bend my leg 15 minutes each, both sides. So then after that, after I did two sets of those, mind you, when the balloon fell out, I was 4. After I did those two sets, I was 9. I was 9 centimeters. Okay, so then they had me sit up, like, you know how the hospital bed, like, sit up. So they had me sitting up like I was in a chair, and they had, like, the bottom of it, like, kind of down a little bit. So it was like I was sitting in the chair, and they was just like, we'll see if this does anything. They was like, bend your knees. So I ended up falling asleep just like that. Because I was on the pain meds. I mean, the pain meds, like, it was a good feeling. So I ended up falling asleep. And then, like, I felt like this little... Like, I woke up. I thought I peed on myself. But really, my water had broke. So I went to the bathroom, wiped everything up. Then I came, as I was coming back, I was carrying a little thing in there and I was trying to hook it up. And I was like, I think my water broke. I was like, I don't know. I was like, can you check? So she checked. She's like, yeah, your water broke. Nah, 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 nah. So she's like, you're gonna start feeling contractions and they're not gonna be like how they was before. So I was like, okay. Like, cause I told them, I was like, if I can't take the pain, then I'll just do the epidural. I really didn't plan on doing the epidural because I was going to try and just like do it natural. Boy, I could not. Them contractions was so fucking strong. Like, I don't see how females say, oh, I did an all natural birth, I didn't do an epidural. No, y'all some thugs, because baby, I was on the phone with my cousin. And they was just like 1 minute apart. And I was just like, ah. And she's like, I can tell. She's like, that baby is coming because your contractions are pretty close. So my water broke. I could feel the contractions through the medicine. I think I'm finna have to get the epidural. This is what my contractions look like. Oh shit. Hey guys, so it's 5:17. I got the epidural around 5. I can't feel nothing. Like, I was just touching my leg and I didn't even know it was my leg until I looked. I can't feel nothing. Like, my leg feels so fake right now. Like, I cannot feel nothing. Like, it feel like, you know that movie Big Mama? When she had them, they had that little fat suit. That's what it looked like. I mean, that's what it feel like, a little fat suit. But I'm so sleepy. I'm sorry, I keep closing my eyes. I'm sleepy as hell. They said I'm having contractions. I can't feel it at all. I can't feel nothing. But I'm sleepy as hell. I'm hungry. I want a pizza. I feel like I got throw up. Yeah. I haven't ate all day. I'm ready for Kai to get here so I can eat. And yeah. The epidural, it really didn't hurt. It felt like a pinch. Because that was like, this the worst part. And then it, I felt a pinch, and then I was having contractions while I was getting the epidural, so they had kept having to stop so I wouldn't move, and I had to control my breathing and all that. But it really didn't hurt like how a lot of people say. I don't know why I was that scared. Hopefully Kai be here by tonight. Yeah, before 12, hopefully. Cause, yeah, I'm finna go to sleep. I look so sick. I'm finna go to sleep though.
And they say, on infant name, they say Gresham. You heard me?
We got moved into another room. Look at the kid. Hey guys, so today is September 13th. It should be like 10 something. Kai is right here. They gave me a birth control shot in my arm, so I'm back on birth control. Kai is really quiet. Like, the only time that she really, like, cries is, like, when you mess with her while she's asleep. Other than that, she don't really cry, yell, none of that. What I was about to say, as far as breastfeeding, when I first gave birth, we did skin to skin. Just trying to breastfeed her. She latched on real quick. But then last night, I tried to breastfeed her. She wouldn't do it. Then, like, 3 o'clock in the morning, tried to do it. She wouldn't do it. So I tried again this morning. She still wouldn't do it. But then again, I just tried, like, 10 minutes ago. And she latched on. So, I think, yes, I'm talking about you. Yes, I'm talking about you. I think that she don't like when people look at her while she's eating and drinking her milk or whatever. Because, like, if I look at her, she'll stop. Bless you, Stinker. Bless you, Stinker. Bless you, Stinker. I look so tired. But, yeah, I think that she don't like when people watch her. Okay, so it's 5:01. We still at the hospital. Kai's right here. Justin's over there. We can't leave until tomorrow because God has to do her 24-hour the test or whatever. And by the time it hit 24 hours that she's been here, it'll be 6:25 and the pediatricians will be gone. So they'll have to come in the morning and then we have to get her birth certificate signed. Well, Justin has to fill out information on the birth certificate. And you gotta show them your ID too. So do that in the morning and hopefully we leave in the morning. I'm ready to go now. But we can't leave. So we didn't leave until I gave birth on the 12th. We didn't leave until that Monday. I gave birth on the 7th. We didn't leave until that Monday. They kept giving us the runaround, said, oh, you can leave tomorrow or you can leave next day. Then another nurse say, oh no, I don't know why she told you that because you won't be leaving that day. So we didn't leave until that Monday around 2 or 3. And because I had to wait on my discharge papers, we had to get her birth certificate signed. Justin had to get the birth certificate signed and all that. Then I was trying to get my WIC stuff situated because they've just been giving me the runaround with that. Still waiting on my voucher with that. And we had went home. I can say the easiest part is that all she do is sleep. Like, I'm surprised she's asleep. I'm surprised she's not asleep right now. All she do is sleep, eat, and shit in peace. Other than that, she don't be woke. I'm surprised she been woke for about an hour. When she is woke, it's because I'm changing her, bathing her, burping her, or she just want her pacifier. Other than that, she's asleep. Little sweet baby. Wanna say hey to YouTube? Where's your sock? Wanna say hey to YouTube? She's so little. Say hey to YouTube. Okay, so that's it for this video. Make sure you subscribe and like the video. My next video, I think, is gonna be probably a 3 or 4 week update on baby K. Yeah, it's probably gonna be that, or I might just do questions in a Q&A video. I don't know. If you have any suggestions, just drop them down in the comments. Make sure you like and subscribe, and see you next time. Oh, and I'm changing the name of the channel since we got a plus one now. Anyway, okay. She don't care. But yeah.